Okay, I'm Don Hall with Visioner Water Quality. I'm the guy that goes throughout the state working with AFLs and CAFLs, do inspections. I've been writing the state rule, basically do everything that has to deal with AFLs and CAFLs. I've been in Utah doing this position for 6 years. I was 10 years in Arizona doing the same thing, working with AFLs and CAFLs. So what we have now is where's the clicker? 2003, EPA issued a new rule, CAFL rule. And then that was taken to court by environmental groups and also to by the industry groups. Can everybody hear me okay? That was taken to court, and then in 2005 they came out with a ruling, and an EPA was required to make some changes to the rule. And then in 2008 they made their ruling. And that's what we're doing now is we're trying to implement a new permit and a new state rule that matches the EPA rule that came out in 2008. We're looking at this summer, probably May, June, of having a state rule finished, and then also in the summer, July, August, we're looking at having a permit issued. Okay, first of all, what's an AFO and CAFO? An AFO is a facility, animal production facility, that confines animals for 45 days or more in a 12-month period, and also feed is brought in to them. So a lot of your pasture and range situations are not AFOs. If you have buildings or pens, corrals, those are probably going to be an AFO. CAFOs are by size. One definition is by size. So for dairies, the 700 cows or more is a large CAFO. For feedlots, 1,000. Then also, a CAFO is a facility, an AFO or CAFO, that requires a permit. And we have, what do we have here? Dairies, I've seen dairy guys, some poultry. We have, I imagine, some feedlot people. Is that all? Do we have anything else? Sheep, okay. Thanks. Okay, so here are the numbers for some of the types of facilities. And so there's small, medium, and large. Small and medium AFOs, and there's large CAFOs. So depending on where you are, depends what kind of discharge requires a permit. So for a feedlot, 300 to 1,000 is a medium, and then under 300 is a small. Okay, so who requires a permit? Facilities that discharge or propose a discharge require a permit. Propose a discharge is an EPA definition, and what that means is a facility that is constructed, designed, operated, or maintained such that a discharge will occur. And so, according to that definition, if you have a facility, you're at your farm, you have a waste, your waste pond is too small, designed too small, and you have a discharge, that is a facility that's proposing a discharge because you weren't adequately constructed or designed. If you require a permit, if you're unpermitted, or if you don't have a permit by rule, which we'll talk about, any discharge is illegal. So if it's 5 inches of rain, if it's a quarter inch of rain, any amount of rain or any amount of snow is illegal without a permit or discharge. So if you're going to be discharging, you have to have a permit or permit by rule. Otherwise, you're subject to enforcement. If you have a permit or a permit by rule, then you're following your permit and you have those kinds of discharges, then those are covered by the permit. So I guess I'll right here. I'll talk about the three. What we have is for the permits. We have the CAFO permit, and when I refer to that, that is the federally based natural, that's from the national headquarters of EPA. That's the federal permit, the CAFO permit. It's based on the federal regulations, and it's mostly going to be for the large CAFOs. Then we have in the state, we'll have a permit by rule, which is based on state rules, and those will be for the AFOs and large CAFOs. So permit by rule is a state permit. And the reason we have this permit by rule in the state is that the producer groups here wanted that provision because if you have, say you went through the process and properly designed your facility and you're a medium AFO and you don't want to get the permit, but you did design your facilities right, but you end up having a discharge, you would be subject to enforcement. So what the permit by rule does is allows you to not have a permit, allows you to discharge if you're following your permit by rule. So it's a way of getting enforcement protection without having to have the full permit. For a large CAFO, any discharge is illegal regardless of the amount. For mediums, for medium CAFO to require a permit, you have to discharge through a man-made device such as a pipe or ditch and something like that, or through direct animal contact with the animals going down into the water or drinking at the edge of the water. And the small CAFOs, they have to be designated. So they discharge the same way mediums do, through direct animal contact or through man-made devices, and they also have to be designated. So I would have to do an inspection and determine that it's a significant source of pollution. For the beef, in the new rule, and the beef is counted the same. It's by numbers. It used to be by animal units, which were based on weights, but now it's based on number of animals. So if you have 1,000, you know, calves or 1,000, you know, cows are counted the same. And the same thing with the poultry. If you have pullets or, you know, the hens or whatever, they're all counted the same. They're not counted separately. The compliance options, if you're a CAFO and you're not discharging or proposing discharge, you can select the permit, and there's some reasons for that. That has the most enforcement protection. You can choose neither the permit or the permit by rule, or you can choose to get the permit by rule. If you choose to get the permit by rule, then there are some certain criteria you have to follow. For the large CAFOs, it's more strict than the AFL permit by rule, as far as basically obtaining the permit by rule. And if you choose neither, there's a risk. There's a risk of, if you have a discharge, of having some enforcement. Okay, so for AFLs, if you're not discharging, you can choose the permit if you want, or the permit by rule, or neither, and again, there's some risk there. Okay, some of the key permit content, this is for the CAFL permit, not the permit by rule. The nutrient management plans have to be public noticed, and so if you have your nutrient management plan, it'll be submitted to me, I review it, then it goes out for public notice for 30 days on our website, and it's open to your neighbor's comments or whoever's comments. If you have the permit by rule, your nutrient management plan is not public noticed, it stays on your site. NMPs, nutrient management plans, will be more field specific now, and which will have much more nutrient management planning in them. Your facility must contain your storm event, the 24-hour event for dairies and feedlots, and for swine and poultry and veal, it's a 100-year storm event. There is more record keeping with the permit than the permit by rule. There's enforcement protections. You'll be inspected at least once every 5 years. This is what we have to do for EPA. Our agreement with EPA is we have to inspect once every 5 years for CAFOs. And then chronic events are covered by the permit also. Okay, so some of the permit by rule content, NMPs are not public noticed. You have the same containment requirements as the permit. There's less record keeping. The permit by rule is obtained basically by submitting a 1 or 2 page application with basic contact information basically. And then there's no charge for the permit by rule. The AFL CAFL permit has a $500 fee for 5 years, so $100 a year basically. And it covers the chronic event, and large will be inspected every 5 years anyway. So if you're a large facility, if you don't want to get the permit, all large facilities have to be inspected once every 5 years at least, whether you have a permit or permit by rule or not. And then you're allowed stormwater exemptions. And stormwater exemptions are where you apply your manure to your field and you incorporate it. Then later it rains and that runoff goes off to a water of the state. Those are legal discharges if you have the permit or the permit by rule. If you choose neither the permit or the permit by rule, the main point here is that you're subject to more enforcement. Okay, here's some of the rule content. So basically, all discharges can be enforced upon. If there's environmental harm, if there's serious environmental harm. You're also, whether you're permitted or not, AFLs and CAFLs are required by statute to report discharges to us. So if you do have a discharge, the law requires you to report to us, to DWQ. And also, AFLs and CAFLs must be properly closed. And so if you remove your animals, you close business, need to remove manure and that kind of stuff from your pens so you're not discharging. Okay, some more rural content. AFLs and CAFLs are allowed return flows. So if you irrigate and your water runs off to a water of a state, those are legal discharges. So also, AFLs are also allowed stormwater discharges, which I didn't talk about earlier. There's your interim management plans for permits and permit by rules have certain requirements they must follow. These are based in the federal regulations. And so a lot of the nutrient management plans may need to be updated. And we have a lot of the planners here. Certified planners must do your permit, must do your nutrient management plan if you have a permit or if you have a permit by rule. And if you're a very small AFO, which we have it written in the rule, so that those are like 28 or less cows for dairy or 40 or less beef for a feedlot, those are very small AFOs, and those don't require a certified planner to do your nutrient management plan.